If this one's actually an updated video on one that I just recently did, but this is an easier workflow, one of the Reflect community members actually built a custom shortcut that lets you transcribe voice notes directly from,
there it is,
Apple Watch, and it will land in your Reflect notes. So I did this as a workflow in our weekly workflow newsletter, which if you haven't subscribed to, you should. You should also subscribe to the YouTube channel. I never ask people to do that, but you really should for my sake. But anyway, I'm just going to kind of go through this process and show you exactly how to do each component. So first, we have to go in and get the OpenAI API keys. To do that, you will need a billing account set up. So that's more than just ChatGPT Pro. You actually have to go in and add a payment method so that you can actually be billed for them. So you'll need to go into OpenAI here and set up that billing account with a payment method and everything. Once you do that, you can generate new API keys. So I will click on the new one there, and you can just give it whatever name you need. You can choose a progress, make sure you give it all permissions, and then you just generate one here and it will show it to you. I'm not gonna actually generate one because I have them connected and I don't want to show it on this video. But it's pretty simple. You'll just need to first set up the billing account so that you can get the API keys there. Okay, so then after you generate the API key, you are good to go on to generate the Reflect access token. And I promise this will all make sense of when you need these later. And I should have probably mentioned as well, when you generate an API key, you need to save it in your notes. It will not. Well, actually, I think the OpenAI one might keep it, but regardless, you should just save it in your notes so that you have it. Then go generate the Reflect access token so you can click on the link. You will need to log in to Reflect, so let me just do that really quick. Okay, so I'm here in Reflect's developer settings page. This is just where you land after logging in. I just didn't want to show that part. And you can see the existing OAuth clients you've created here, but you're going to create a new one. And, you know, you can give it whatever name you want. So I could do, or let me say, Apple Watch voice notes. I'll call it a demo so that I know what it is. And then you'll just put in reflect.app for the name. And for the redirect URL, you can just use the localhost. So I put this in the instructions, so I'll put a link to this in the YouTube video, but you can just go in and copy that, whoops, and then go paste it in there. Once you have those elements, then you create a client. I'm gonna delete this one right after since it's showing everyone this information, but you get the client ID, the client secret, and then you generate an access token and it will copy it to your clipboard. And again, you wanna save that. So once you have these, you're all good to go. You have the keys and whatnot you need. And we can now move on to the actual custom shortcut. So click on this link. It will take you to this page and you can just click Get Shortcut. And it will ask you to open up the Shortcuts app. And it will bring you to this page and you can just click Add Shortcut. And here you will see all the spaces to input everything. So here you'll input your Reflect graph or profile ID. So for me, it's just Sam Clausen. For the Reflect access token, that's going to be what you just generated. So I can paste that in there. And your OpenAI API key. You know what? Let me go ahead and make a test one. Just so that I can actually do this in the full sense of the demo. So I'll go delete this afterwards and change it. But shortcut, that's what I wanted. Okay. There's that. And I'm not going to do these. Yeah, I'm just going to kind of do the basic shortcut. But as you see, there will be a lot of editing options. Cool. And so now this is here on the shortcut. So I'm all set. And you can double click on it and it gives you all of these options. There's a bunch of different formatting things and whatnot you can change, but you don't have to. So I'm just going to leave mine straight out of the box. And then all that's left, if I go back to kind of my instructions here, is to go add the shortcut into the Apple Watch and give it a try. So because of the, I don't have a great way to do screen sharing on Apple Watch, so I'm going to switch to kind of normal third person video and show you that. And then we will see how it appears right within Reflect. Okay, so now we're ready to add the shortcut to my actual Apple Watch. So I'll click and hold on the screen and click edit. And you can choose whatever widget you want depending on your design. I'll replace this stopwatch one. And you're gonna go up and find the shortcuts. So we'll tap on that. And then right below here, you can see that we have the reflect audio notes that I just added. So I can tap on that. And that's pretty much it. I can hit my button now to stop editing. And now when I tap this button, I have the option to run reflect audio notes. Oh, I need to click allow. Perfect. And then it starts transcribing an audio note. And by the way, once you click allow, you won't have to do that the second time. So that's just one extra step this time. We've done recording. You can just click the stop button and it will transcribe it. And then we'll go check it out within our reflect notes. Okay, so now I'm just back in my Reflect Daily Note, and you can see that what I just recorded on that video from my Apple Watch now appears just like any other audio memo that I would record in Reflect underneath a backlinked audio memo note. So that's pretty much it. And then once you click allow on the permissions, you can just kind of do it with that one tap and start recording from your Apple Watch. That's pretty much it.